Boulevard.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Boulevard Drive-In. My name is Jack Posegre. This is the beginning of the 68th season continuous operation of the Boulevard. Truly the classic drive-in theater in the Midwest. But tonight, a special celebration of dedication to the longtime Boulevard Drive-In owner, the one and only Wes Neal. Would you believe he begins his 65th year here at the Boulevard and he didn't drown through all those floods? Wes also reaches another major milestone in his life. He will be celebrating his 90th birthday later this year. Now, while grandson Brian Neal now manages the operation here, Wes remains fully involved in the day-to-day operations, running around the field, making sure the speakers all work. He's around here all weekend, swapping, shopping, and doing all that. And I first got to know Wes back in the late 70s when I was working at Commonwealth Theaters, and then later in the mid-80s during those infamous KY-102 all-night blowouts. I don't think Wes has ever forgiven me for those. At this point, I would like to introduce Mr. Butch Rigby. He's the owner of a legend in his own mind. No. Butch is the owner of Screenland Theaters here in Kansas City. He's also the past president of the Film Society of Greater Kansas City. And he has a few remarks about the true dedication of Wes Neal. Butch?
All right, wonderful. Well, hey, welcome everybody. It's going to be a wonderful night at the drive-in. 68th year in a row, 65th under the command of Mr. Wes Neal. But I first met Wes many years ago, back in the late 80s, when I was just getting ready to go out to Hollywood and work movie crews. And when I came back, I had met John Shipp, and he introduced me to everybody in the business. And Wes has always served as sort of a mentor to all of us. And, not just myself, but John Shipp and the people here. And he's a great example, not of just a great showman, but also the great example of a way to run a business and how to do business with people. And that's why he's still in business 65 years later. But I'll tell you a great little story. A few years ago, and if anybody ever thought Wes Neal was going to retire, this is the story that proves they're mistaken. One day I get a telephone call from Wes. He goes, "Butch, can you come on down to the Boulevard? I want to talk a little business." I'm like, "Oh, well, certainly. So I hung up, and I was talking to John Shipp, and I said, "Hey, I think Wes might be ready to retire, and maybe he wants to make this a Screenland under the stars, a Screenland drive." And John's going, "Well, that'd be pretty cool." So we go down there, we get down here, and we get to talking, and he's got us in the office, and we're kind of talking about everything, and finally he goes, "Okay, let's get down to business. You know, Charlie Wheeler and I have been working on a monorail to go downtown for the past 45 years, and we think you're just the man to put that deal together." So we walked over, and Wes, is that monorail car still over there? The old sled, anyway, yeah. So, but I was honored. I mean, I was not in a position to work on it, but you know what? It's that kind of forethinking, you know, and of course, what do we have today? We have a streetcar in Kansas City, and this guy was talking about it years ago, and connecting Kansas City, Kansas, and connecting Kansas City, Missouri. I also, at one time, Wes and I were the only two motion picture operators in Wyandotte County when I owned the Granada Theater in downtown Kansas City, Kansas. Wes lasted a bit longer than I did. I think we made it through about two seasons. Anyway, so with that, I want to say it is an honor and it's a privilege to be here yet again with Wes Neal and with his talented family. And Brian, you are a chip off the old block, and you are such a great showman and new ideas and still sticking to the old traditions of the old school of business. So thank you all for having us, and welcome everybody to another season at the Drive-In.
Thanks, Butch. And now a very special treat, a big screen montage of Wes Neal's many local television appearances as produced by Brian Esern and his My Forever Films productions. I think you're going to enjoy this. You'll see Wes aging as the montage goes on. Let's take a look on the big screen. To introduce to you the second most important person here at the Boulevard Drive-In, next to Wes, his grandson, Brian Neal.
Thank you. Thank you all for coming out tonight, and especially thank you to Wes, Grandpa, for all of his hard work over the many, many years keeping this place open. Before I hand the mic over to him, I'd like to invite my wife out. She's really the second most important person here. She runs the snack bar, Clarissa. Yeah. Grandpa.
Brian and I would like to present you with these Boulevard Drive-In memorabilia scrapbooks documenting the history of the drive-in, your history here, full of all kinds of articles, all kinds of good stuff. So thank you very much for keeping this place alive. We appreciate it.
Thank you. You know, I want to thank Wes for doing all this hard work and teaching me everything that he knows about this drive-in. And here he is.
Woo-hoo! Yeah, thank you, Brian. Well, I did teach him everything I know in about 10 seconds.
10 seconds.
But he's learned well. He didn't have to be talked very much because he's smarter than me. And I'm sure glad to have him. I don't know what we've done without him. But I want to thank you all for coming out tonight. I'm sure happy to see you here. And hope you'll come back all during the summer. Because we're, like all you people, we love you all. And we look forward to seeing you all through the season this year. And we thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Brian, Ike, Clarissa. Thank you again.